Welcome to Inside Boxing's Throwdown. My name is Aurelio Martinez, and Eric Duran, my host, Sugarfoot. What we're going to do is in this segment, we're going to talk about the Floyd Mayweather versus Marcos Maidana. Now, it's official, okay? There's been a lot of talk in the past about who he's going to fight, Amir Khan, everything. Everyone and their mothers wants to get in on this Floyd Mayweather lottery. Well, it's official now. It's official now, May 3rd. We're going to see Floyd Mayweather and Marcos Maidana. And we're going to talk about that here in this segment. And we also got other segments. We're going to talk about his father and the Guerrero fiasco that's going on. We'll get your take on that. And we'll also talk about the upcoming fight this weekend. Eric, why don't we go ahead and start with the Floyd Mayweather. Let's talk about this fight, finally.
Yeah, you know what's funny is I actually had a close personal friend reach out to me and say, I have an inside source. Mayweather is actually going to pull out of the May 3rd fight with an injury. And if anyone knows me, they know, you know, I'm one of Floyd Mayweather's biggest fans. I know a lot of people in his gym. So I'm like, you know what? I need to reach out to some of my sources. Reached out to my sources. They said, no worries. It's a go. He knows who he's going to fight. They're just waiting to, you know, release a statement. And of course...
Now, was this before or after the Maidana announcement?
This was before the... This was about 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
So for about 2 weeks, I sat on my inside source of them saying that, you know, the fight's a go. You know, they're just waiting for the announcement. And of course, he waited in Mayweather fashion. He just celebrated his 37th birthday with the announcement of his May 3rd fight. The crazy part about it, though, is it might not land at MGM Grand Resorts, which Mayweather in the past has stated MGM stands for Mayweather Getting Money.
Wow.
There's a buzz out there that it could land at the Barclays Center.
Well, that's going to be interesting because I'm going to tell you what, Floyd just does not fight out of Las Vegas.
Exactly.
Las Vegas is his home, his pride and joy, his glory. That's Floyd Mayweather. Wow, I find it hard to believe that we'll see Floyd fighting anywhere else.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's get back to his opponent, though.
Okay.
Mayweather set up all these polls. Well, actually, he just set up the poll on the Mayweather site.
Yeah.
But everyone else ran with it. ESPN, Fight News, Boxing Talk, all these big social media, Twitter, you know, Facebook, they all have their polls of Maidana and Khan.
Yes.
Maidana won on every poll except the Mayweather poll. So for Mayweather to go against his own poll and pick Maidana, I think Mayweather realized, hey, Maidana is the more respected fighter here, and I'm going to get more publicity in fighting someone who was perceived as a tougher opponent for me.
Well, you know, it's kind of hard to say, but I think what we have is we have to weigh out the value of the opponent. Okay, now naturally. Amir Khan, many people see him as the tougher opponent because of his hand speed and his slickness. Okay, mm-hmm. Many people see him as the weaker opponent because he doesn't have the chin.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but the bottom line is the quality of the opponent, who's going to bring and who's going to generate the most revenue. Money
exactly.
Mayweather is about money. Okay, now naturally Amir Khan will not generate the same amount of money as Maidana here in the United States.
Exactly, yes. Okay.
So now Floyd has to weigh out, do I make this fight and go fight in the UK? You know, because then it's big money.
Then it's huge money.
It's huge. I mean, it's just huge. Or do I stay home and fight Maidana, which is also going to be huge money.
Exactly.
Okay, because I'm going to be honest with you. It's just one of them things where a lot of fights on the title level when you're fighting up there, I don't really care to pay the $60, the pay-per-view money, to see him, okay?
Yeah.
The Maidana-Mayweather fight, guess what? I'm going to watch that fight.
Exactly. And so. It's also a lot about what have you done for me lately.
Yeah.
As far as Maidana, his last three opponents have been Josito Lopez, a hard-nosed B-level fighter.
Yep.
Jesus Soto Carras, another B-level fighter. But then he stepped up, and we both perceived Adrian Broner as a low-level, A-level fighter.
Yes.
And it wasn't even a close fight.
Yes.
Whereas in Amir Khan, I think the last guy he fought was Julio Diaz, where he was dropped, midway through the fight, staggered a few times later in the fight.
Yes, yes.
And, won a relatively close decision.
Yes, yes.
Maidana earned this fight. And people say, he's hitting his lottery. No, he ain't hitting the lottery. He earned the right to step in the ring with Floyd Mayweather.
Good point, Eric. Good point. He earned. He worked his way toward this fight. And this is a fight that the public wants to see now. Let's face it. They want to see this. They don't want to see him fight anyone else. They don't want to see him fight. Because Floyd has fought in the past opponents that have not been the public's selection. I mean, the Ghost Guerrero. I mean, everybody knew that was just a money fight for Guerrero.
Exactly.
There was no way that anyone out there thought Guerrero would win.
But this can be a changing of the guard, because in his last fight, people wanted to see Canelo.
Yes.
In this fight, people want to see Maidana.
Two back-to-back.
He'll probably fight in September. Hopefully someone emerges a la Danny Garcia.
Yes.
And that fight can be made.
Yes.
And there's still the rumblings that, Pacquiao will not re-sign with Top Rank at the end of the year. And the fight will eventually be made in 2015.
So I think the good thing I like about it all, and the way the scenario is starting to flatten out, is Floyd Mayweather and his exit out of boxing is going to be grand.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be grand. You're talking about Canelo. You're talking about Maidana. You're talking possibly Danny Garcia. And then you're talking about maybe, and that's a big maybe, a Pacquiao. The thing about it is even without the Pacquiao.
Yeah.
Okay, because I think right now, today, I think Pacquiao's starting to fall on the popularity list of the opponents.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And another name we could throw out there is Miguel Cotto and Sergio Martinez have an upcoming fight in the summer.
That's right.
If Martinez wins that fight, I don't see why Floyd can't go up to 154 and fight Martinez if he really wants to, make a statement on his way out of boxing.
And I'm with you. I don't think that'll be a problem. I really don't think that's going to be a problem. There's not too many people out there that you can say will pose a danger or become a real big problem for Floyd.
I think that's the problem, that a lot of people, tend to throw under the carpet when talking with Floyd. They always say, the Manny Pacquiao fight. Okay, besides the Manny Pacquiao fight, who else was out there for him to fight that he didn't fight? They talk about Sugar Ray Leonard and Thomas Hearns and Marvin Hagler and Roberto Duran. Well, all those guys were at the same weight at the same time. They have to fight each other.
You had a pool of fighters.
Who else has Mayweather not fought that he should have fought besides Manny Pacquiao?
Yes. I agree with you. I just like the way, I just like the way this whole, call it the end of his career, because, obviously a fighter has to retire sooner or later, okay? And I don't see and I don't perceive Floyd Mayweather doing like a Roy Jones Jr., where you're on top of the world, you're the greatness, the fastest hands, and then you just stick in the game long enough to where people just kind of forget of who you were, okay? So I don't think that's going to happen with Floyd.
It's because he's built an empire, and, he don't call himself money for no reason. He has money in the bank. Anyone who knows boxing knows that Roy Jones has had financial problems over these last couple years that forced him to stay in the game so that he can pay his bills.
Yes.
I don't think Mayweather's going to have that problem when he retires.
No, he won't. As a matter of fact, Floyd, from what I understand, and I know Floyd, we were in his training camp on a number of occasions, two or three times with my fighter, Donald Camarena. So it's not like I'm just saying Floyd, and I don't know him. I personally know Floyd. And Floyd is a good guy. You see him on the street level, just outside of the cameras and all that. Great guy. I mean, he's a great guy. I mean, what I'm saying is he is what boxing should have. Can you imagine if there's two or three Floyds right now at this time in this era? I mean, boxing would just
but it's crazy. It's hard though, because Adrian Broner tried it and he got beat. In order to be Floyd Mayweather, you can't just be flashy. You can't just get on a camera and, you know, talk this, talk that, you have to be able to back it up in the ring. That's why there isn't too many Floyd Mayweathers.
Yeah.
Because they can do it all and still get in the ring and put on a dominant performance.
Yeah, you're right. It's easy to flush money down the toilet. Okay? You know,
but if you ain't backing it up,
but yeah, exactly.
People are going to get tired of it real quick. Yes. You know, and as soon as you lose, they've been waiting to jump on you.
Okay. Let's talk about the fight itself a little bit, Eric. How do you see this fight? Give us some points on what Maidana has to do to have a chance.
Well, you know what? This reminds me of a classic fight that was even before my time. But, you know, I watch tapes of older fights. This has Sugar Ray Leonard, Roberto Duran 1 written all over it. If Maidana can pressure Mayweather, get him out of his comfort zone, get him into a knockdown, drag him out type of fight like Duran did the first time with Leonard,
mm-hmm.
he has a chance at winning. But if Floyd fights Maidana like Leonard did Duran the second time, and just boxes his head off, stays on the outside, hits him with shots he doesn't see, it's a one-sided fight. And quite honestly, I think that's how it's going to play out. I think Floyd Mayweather is the type of fighter that he fights his style. You are not going to get him into fighting your style. And unless you can break that defense, break mm-hmm. that will, you don't stand a chance.
Well,
because obviously, Maidana's a heavy-handed fighter, but so was Canelo, and Canelo couldn't touch him.
Well, I agree. Maidana is... What gives Maidana a chance, and I'm going to agree with you, is his conditioning. Okay, Robert Garcia will have him in the best shape, just like when he fought
mm-hmm.
Adrian Broner, because it's awfully hard to fight 12 rounds throwing them whoppers of punches, being aggressive, using your power. If you're going to utilize your power for 12 rounds, you have to be in tip-top shape.
Exactly.
Okay. Same thing happens if you're going to utilize 12 rounds of boxing mm-hmm. and mobility. You have to be in tip-top shape.
Exactly.
Now, I think what this brings to the table... We know Floyd's always in tip-top shape. We know he's in shape. That
Floyd can take 6 months off and step into a 12-round fight.
He's a gym rat. He lives for training. Mm-hmm. That's just the way he is. So we know he's going to be in good shape.
Exactly.
We know McDonough's going to be in shape. He proved that against Adrian Broner. Mm-hmm. He was on a mission on that fight. He wasn't going to get tired. Now, at the very end, he showed some signs of tiring.
But he fought 12 hard rounds. And Broner didn't give up. That's the thing.
Yeah.
Broner, you know... Even though he lost and even though people jumped on him, man, he showed some heart. He showed some guts.
Oh, he
could have gave up. He could have got out of there.
And nobody would have blamed
exactly.
him.
Exactly.
I mean, he was taking some shots. So I think that's going to be key in this Floyd McDonough fight is there's number one, conditioning.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Both fighters, you have to expect both fighters that are going to come in tip-top shape. I mean, without a doubt. The key for McDonough is unlike the other opponents that have come in, and I'm talking about name opponents. Maidana's not necessarily coming in here for the payday. Now, mm-hmm. naturally, it is a payday, and he knows that. I mean,
but there's certain fighters you know who come,
but he's
for
coming,
the respect.
But he comes to fight.
Yeah, exactly.
And he knows he's going to come to try to win this fight. Mm-hmm. Unlike the other fights, especially like the Guerrero, he didn't come to win that fight. He won the lottery. Okay, so different scenario. McDonough's going to come to fight. How is Floyd going to take his pressure? Okay, mm-hmm. Is he going to elect to stay mobile and for 12 rounds and score and move and score and move? Or is he going to actually stop, do his pick and choosing when he's going to slug it out? And do
yeah.
that? I expect that's what he's going to do because Floyd loves to punish his opponents,
mm-hmm.
not only in sparring, not only in the fight, but in sparring.
Exactly.
He will pride himself in bringing you to his camp and sending you home. In other words, when you come to sparring, he's going to pay you well. You're going to get paid.
But you're going to pay a price.
But he's going to send you home. So I mean, when you spar with Floyd, it ain't like you're back home in your gym where you're just sparring with your fellow stablemate.
Exactly.
You're in there paying the price, mm-hmm. or you better be on your execution.
You know, and that's the thing is people say, well, Mayweather doesn't knock anyone out, he doesn't hit hard. Those guys get in the ring with him, they ain't standing there trying to trade with him after he's, you know, hit him for 8 rounds, after he's pop shot at him, after he's hit him with shots they haven't seen, you know.
Well,
he does damage.
We've been in the camp a number of times, you know, when I took Donald Cummins in it. So I saw when he's in there sparring with Chop Chop Corley and Sugar Shea Collins and all the, them guys, they in there and they take a butt whipping and they have to fight back, because if you don't fight back, you're going to get beat up. You might as well get out of there.
Home.
You get that plane and go home. But, you know, it's just the sight to be able to see. I wish the public can actually see inside the training camp when Floyd actually incorporates sparring for a fight. Yeah. I mean, it's in a whole different world of its own.
Let me pose a question for you. You're a well-respected trainer out here in Colorado. I feel like if you took the time, you can be a world-class, you know, trainer at this level, such as a Robert Garcia. Well, what is Robert Garcia's main focus in this camp?
Again, his main focus, number one, is conditioning. Okay, you've got to remember, as a trainer, you can't train every fighter, every boxer out there to the way you train.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you have to be adaptable. You have to have an eye. And although fighters seem to be the same and they seem to have the same style, they don't. Every fighter is independent. So what you have to do is you have to work on the strong holds that a fighter has, and don't worry so much about the weak. Build on the strong holds. In other words, Maidana's stronghold is aggressive, straightforward, and his power. Okay, if you take a look at Maidana, he doesn't have a lot of style points.
Mm-hmm.
He's not going to sit there and slip and move and slip and move and jab and twist and turn and roll with the punch. He's not going to do all that. Okay,
he's going to take two to give one.
Yeah. So right now, in his career, you don't spend time trying to teach him that. It's beyond that. So what you do is you just go ahead and take the time to work on his best attributes. Right now, shape. He's got to be in tip-top shape to be able to throw power shots for 12 rounds. Okay? You got to build up the neck, the chin, everything else. You got to show him how to put the chin down so that he can take the punches, because he's going to get hit. Okay? He's got to be able to take the punches and keep delivering. That's going to be key in this fight. If Floyd hits him, pop with solid punches, and he's able to withstand him and continue to come and put the pressure on Floyd, changes the game. Okay.
Exactly.
That's what he has to work. And that's Robert. That's got to be the whole thing with Roberto Garcia right now. He's got to focus on conditioning, a lot of mitt work, a lot of power punching, a lot of bag work. A lot of hitting the tire,
mm-hmm.
a lot of slamming the slam ball, these type of exercises that are going to get him in shape to go 12 rounds.
A good observation. Before we wrap this up.
Okay. All right, sorry about that. Our computer is telling us time.
Yeah, before we wrap this up, I just want to, you know, look directly in the camera and talk to fight fans, whoever watched this, please do not take the Maidana-Broner fight and think that that was a blueprint to beat Mayweather. Mayweather is the blueprint that every fighter is trying to get to. It's not Adrian Broner. They're two totally different fighters if you actually watch tape on them. So please do not run with that fight and think, oh man, I think Maidana's really going to get Mayweather. Mayweather is a step above Broner. He's a step above most of these fighters out there. It will be a good fight. I just think Mayweather's too much at this point for a slow-footed fighter like Maidana.
And I'm going to tell you, I'm going to concur with him, most of it anyhow, because I think Floyd right now, his past experience and knowledge of boxing in the ring is far superior to any fighter out there right now. Okay, I think he's going to be able to capitalize on the lack of skills and the lack of talent Maidana has. And I think he'll be able to elude the power punches. I'm not sure Maidana is going to be able to hit Floyd with a significant punch. In saying that, I'm not saying he will not hit Floyd. Okay, you're going to hit Floyd. But he's not going to hit him where the power is at the end of the punch. So in saying that, I see Floyd actually stopping Maidana in the late rounds, in the championship rounds. I think you're going to see Maidana gassed out. You're going to see his hands drop. You're going to see the power drop. My observation is Floyd will win by a TKO in the last three rounds. So
stick with us. We're going to take a quick break. We'll return with Julio Cesar Chavez versus Brian Vera, as well as Vasily Lemachenko's going for a world title in his second fight. So stick with us. We'll be back in a short period of time.
All right. Come back. We'll be back in a short period.